Morning. Good morning. Oh, hey, look, I'm up. Of course I'm up. I'm changed. I'm ready. I'm good to go. Welcome. It's match day. This is part two of the Back of the Net match day vlog. If you've not seen the first part, then check it out. Card is at the top of the screen. My name's Sam Davis. I'm here with Tom, Sandy, Lucy and Heather. We stayed in West Brom last night. People are asking why. Because we had a non-refundable yet movable hotel for our rescheduled match due to the fourth round of the FA Cup. So we were here, we thought we'd use it. Next, it's on the way to Blackpool. Firstly, time for breakfast. Beautiful Blackpool.
Jesus, our seaside town is better than yours. It is grim, but I love it.
It's beautiful. Look, it's raining, it's windy, it's cold.
What an away day.
What an away day. You know what though, we split up quite nicely. Look, when I ended the vlog last night, I uploaded it and then I thought, why didn't I play, whoa, we're halfway there.
Should have. We'll be living on a prayer in 80 minutes, mate.
So we travelled, as you know, from part one of the vlog to West Brom, and part two was a swift drive to Blackpool, mate.
Yeah, it was a couple of hours, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was not too bad at all. So we finally have arrived in the Las Vegas of the North, walking up to, what's the pub called?
The Manchester is what it's called, you told me, Sam. Yeah, I've passed about 12 chip shops in about a 5 minute walk. unbelievable, a few sticks of rock, a few horses about. It's all going on, mate. But yeah, just get me in there now, see some chairs, just take home the 3 points.
Come on, let's do this. Beautiful Blackpool. More beautiful. It is the first time we can actually hear a voice in the last
absolutely
hour
bouncing
and a half.
In there.
Mate, it's bouncing. Sorry, there's been no fan cam so far, but we'll chat to a few people on the way.
You can't hear anything. It's
2 o'clock. Team news is out. Tom, what the hell's going on, mate?
Yeah, well, we saw briefly, didn't we, that Jacob Tanswell said that Christie's out, and he is correct, and Kiefer Moore as well. So Travis remains a goal. Obviously, Phillips and Kelly are still the centre halves, and Zamora and Stacey the fullbacks. But obviously, with Lerma's suspension, Lewis Cook has gone into that role, with Bidden and Cantwell still in front. Then he's got Anthony and Dembele either side of Dominic Solanke. South bench of Woodman, Mepham, Hill, Davis, Pearson, Marcondes and Lowe. No Kenny on the bench. Cahill's got an injury, he's not on the bench. Moore's got an injury, he's not on the bench. Still strong, but yeah, we're without a few, mate. Ryan Christie, big blow.
Really surprised that Pearson hasn't been brought into this, mate. Really surprised.
He's got Lewis Cook. Yeah, we know he can do it on his day, but I thought he'd go Pearson today, but yeah. Lewis Cook going to be sat in that deep role, mate, so see how he gets on. But we've got we're without Lerma for 4 games, so Lewis Cook's got a game or two to prove himself. If he doesn't, then Pirlo's there to step in, isn't he? So, yeah, just a shame about Christie, and Moore already injured. It's a blow.
Are we going to get back in and enjoy the disco, mate?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Bangers in there. So that Spandau Ballet. Get me in there already. Chez, come on.
Welcome to disgusting toilets. I mean, have you ever seen a toilet that needs to prop itself up?
2 out of 10.
On the way to the stadium, buddy. The Manchester was a bit of an experience, wasn't it, eh?
Bit lively.
Hello, department!
Bit lively,
what,
wasn't it?
What an experience that was.
DJ playing some proper bangers.
Like, loud. I couldn't hear anyone. What's your prediction for today, buddy?
I said 1-0. I'm still sticking with 1-0 Dembele.
Yeah.
And he's starting.
He is starting. Look, mate, this is how seriously... Well, they know this is being treated, right?
The Bournemouth's back in town. Bournemouth's
back horses, in town. That's what we're all about. Anyway, hopefully a good game. Hopefully a good spirit. 2-1.
If it was me, I would have switched Lerma for Pearson, just to give us that bite in midfield, but I think we'll be okay. We've got the option to bring him on, I think, every week to the bench. So,
what's your prediction?
I'd say a hard-fought draw, probably a 2-2.
We've got Super Scotty Parker!
How are you, buddy? You alright? Hey, last saw you at Yeovil, great days. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad.
How are you feeling about today?
Confident.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm confident. Everyone else, not too sure. But
yeah,
I'm
feeling a bit not too sure. What's your prediction?
2-0.
What's your team lineup?
Good. Yeah. I think we've got a strong team. I reckon we're going to do well. 2-0.
Hello, mate. Prediction for today, buddy.
2-0 win.
Everyone's loving it. 5 minutes to kick off. Introduce yourself to the net viewers.
This is the first time I've been on it, actually. I'm honoured. Usually I just say hi and that's it. But, mate, let's do it.
Thoughts for today?
It should be all right. Scotty got the leashes off in the last match and then he's got to do the same this match because, I mean, you probably heard it before. Passing out the back. We got amazing players. Let's just keep going forward. Same way. In 2015, just keep attacking. Who cares if we concede a few? So be it. Just outscore them all the time. We've got amazing players.
What's your prediction then? Go on.
It's either 2-0 or 3-1. I'm going to go ambitiously 4-0 now. The beard's kicking in. The dark fruit's kicking in.
4-0 if that happens.
4-0. 4-0 if it happens.
What three numbers from this guy?
Yeah, exactly.
Trav, my man, my boy, my man, my angel, my guardian.
Get it in, Jack. Go on, Jackie. Go on, Jackie, my baby. Good delivery here. Good delivery. That's a nice. Tickled it. Tickled it. Tickled it. Oh, that's a pen. Yeah, he's given it. He's given a pen. He's given a penalty. It's an absolute penalty.
Sam, definitely.
Stonewall.
Stonewall penalty.
Swinging for a short.
Yeah, and he clipped his heels.
Yeah, clipped his heels. That's a pen. Come on, you.
Come on.
Dobbs. Yeah, used to be scuffs. 21 this week. Come on, Dominic, my baby. Pen, you know what you're doing. It's that tricky.
I said you should have gone down the middle.
He runs up to it and doesn't look at the ball at all.
It was a poor penalty.
Poor arse. Time to put it right, Dom. Popwell will only save today. Or Dom Slanky.
Half time, mate. It's shocking.
We're back
with vengeance. I mean, look, poor penalty by Dom.
Yeah, I did see it. I always look round, mate.
Oh, did you not see it?
Yeah, I saw the reaction of the fans.
He telegraphed it, and when does he not put it to the right?
That's what I would say.
Never.
Yeah,
always does that.
I don't know if it was a pen.
And when you put it to the right, when you, like, he approaches it square on, he telegraphs it so much. It's like so obvious he's going to do that. You can't telegraph it as much if you're going to put it to the other side. He always puts it to the right. And a good save, and then we were punished.
He was always going to score, wasn't he?
Brutal way.
Bowler. He was always going to score, wasn't he?
Great goal, though.
Yeah, it looked a good finish. But yeah, it's been boring. I mean, it's just been pretty nothing game, isn't it? What we're used to, really. But
have we ever shot a goal apart from the actual pen?
I think we've had two, but with pen obviously included. But to be fair, I think the problem is, go a goal behind. We said this on the second look, haven't we?
Yeah.
Then I worry. I don't see us coming out again too. I just don't see it, mate.
No.
But hopefully they prove me wrong. If we can nick a one all now, I'll rip your hand off.
AFCB Adam, how are you, mate?
I'm good, but it's embarrassing again. Solanke pen, why is he not just smashing? He's not Jorginho.
I know.
Smash it. The keeper's died before he's taken the pen, and he's still put it that way.
I mean, great goal by Josh Bowler, wasn't it? But
yeah, he's class.
But have we had a shot on target apart from Dom's penalty?
We had one more. It's embarrassing against Blackpool, and I know they're up there now, but start of season, if we drew against them at home,
yeah.
We lose it at 1 point against a relegation team,
yeah.
It's embarrassing,
yeah.
Look at Fulham, they're running away these games. I know they drew against them, but they're winning games 4-3-0,
yeah.
We ain't got a chance to catch them. We've got to focus on the teams behind us. Blackpool now,
yeah,
it's
scary.
Oh.
Any? Can you give any credit to anyone during this half, any standout players?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Potentially, I mean, the odds of walking all over us, though, it's a real shame. Hopefully, the second half, we're going to have a smash it.
Yeah.
It's really kind of fun.
Apart from Lewis Cook.
Yeah. And Lewis Cook hasn't been good recently.
I don't know
what to expect.
I feel so depressed, mate. I thought he was going to start well with
it. The issue is, I don't feel like we're going to score.
No, I don't think we are.
And it's the first time in years I haven't felt, oh, we can win this match.
Yeah.
Especially, yeah, it's what it is. Hopefully,
yeah.
Second half, Jamal Lowe or something.
Come on, team's coming out.
Pitch is bad.
We
go.
We scored a goal. That's all we got. Oh my god! Wow. They just hit the bar. Free kick, partially cleared. Shot from the edge of the area. And it hit the basically as far in the corner as you could get. Go. That's a hell of a save from Travers, my god. You know what's worse about that save? What's worse about that save is I could see the guy coming in about 5 seconds before he headed it. Come on, lads. Got to fucking sort it out here. Can't see with Toddy. Get in! Nice lock. Oh. Thank you.
my God!
Here outside Bloomfield Road with Alan, who's a Blackpool fan. I don't know what to say, mate. I feel as though it's daylight robbery today. How are you feeling?
I think you're playing well. That's 18 minutes in the game, and then the first half. We got the first one back, and you got one back.
Yeah.
And your players scored the last goal before the end.
I know. But you're going to be all right this season, aren't you?
Yeah.
You're going to be absolutely fine. You've got some good players. Josh Bowler. Great player for you.
Who's the best player we got?
Yeah.
That goal we saw, the first one. Wait!
It's blooming amazing.
It's a bloody belter one.
Yeah. Whereabouts are you going to finish this season, do you think?
We're still about 14th play at the moment.
14th, yeah. Mate, nice to meet you, Alan. Take care. Enjoy your burger, it looks well tasty. I'm going to leave you to eat it in peace. I'm going to leave you to eat it in peace, buddy. Anyway, up the tangerines, up the cherries. We'll see you later.
Yeah.
Nice one. Take care.
Keep it for sale,
yeah. Yeah, we'll do. We'll do. Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Back yeah. Back.
Up the cherries. So there we go. We're leaving Bloomfield Road. If I'm honest, not entirely sure what he said. I think I'll just leave it at that.
Siriki Dembele.
That is lovely of Blackpool, isn't it?
Mate, what a lovely touch.
We wore green today. We scored 92.
What can you do?
Look at that, lovely touch. Gone green for us. Blackpool, such a hospitable town.
Love it.
And Bree, Thomas Jordan, we've just done the free for all. Yep. That was interesting. I'm sorry to try to bring you back down to earth, yeah. But I kind of felt as though we skanked it, but a win's a win, isn't it? And yeah. Anyway, look, we got 3 points, we're healthy. Not all AFC Bournemouth fans are doing healthy things at this time. What have you heard?
Jackson! I've heard about Jackson Senior, Richard Jackson. I've heard he's hurt his shoulder, might be dislocated.
Oh, mate.
From the limb. So yeah, hope he's alright. Yeah, Mark was telling me, I think it was during the celebrations, that he's dislocated his shoulder, he's in the medical room, so...
There's us going on about, mate. Lindsay Lohan, he's dislocated...
Hope he's alright, legend, isn't he? God, legend. So we were with him virtually all day, weren't we?
Yeah.
I was sat in front of him, so I hope he's alright. Hope you're alright, Jackson. I know what he's like. He'll go, I'll take a dislocated shoulder for a win, because he's all about the 3 points. But yeah,
Richard,
hope you're alright, mate.
Get well soon, buddy. The housewife's favourite cannot
no.
have a dislocated shoulder for future games. I see that Mark's been on Twitter posting some well wishes, and hopefully you'll get some AFCB love on Twitter and maybe in person as well. Mate, get well soon, buddy. That's
horrible, isn't it? It's horrible. But Jack, I know Jackson, he'll be going, I expect Tom to still be having limbs, so I'll try to escape shoulder and pop well for you, mate. Love ya.
It's suddenly become nighttime, mate.
Oh, mate, I'm still on the way day limbs. I'm still living off them.
We're in, look at this. Police cars. Sirens, the lot. Ugh. Welcome to Blackpool. And look, we're going to go out, we're going to take you on our evening together, yeah. And we can't wait.
Hot world, let's give it some. Come on, Siriki.
Hi there, back from the night out, and enjoyable one that, really good, met a load of Cherries fans out and about in town, and yeah, ready for bed now. I tell you what, it's freezing out, absolutely freezing, but just reflecting on today, and obviously delighted with the win, absolutely delighted. And in Dembele, we've got a player that's confident to take players on. I was just thinking of the angle that he scored that goal from. And in a few circumstances in that Boreham Wood game, Jack Stacey was in the exact same position but opted to square it or cross it. Whereas Dembele took it on, that shows confidence. Last kick of the game, the pressure that he had, and he decided to do that. That's the type of mentality that we need, and it needs to be infectious throughout the whole side, because sometimes I feel as though we've been a bit safe, especially overplaying it in the last third. And look, he turned up and it was almost a scuff shot when I'm looking at the replay, but I tell you what a win. Limbs at the end, and Richard Jackson, as we said earlier, really hope you're doing okay. So yeah, 3 points we needed. The league table looks really good. I'll put it on screen now. It's all right, isn't it? It's not too bad. It looks really promising, and sometimes you just got to claw out these horrible victories and then it still gives you confidence. And in someone like Dembele that's looking to take players on, forward thinking, I think we've got a star. I really, really do like him. And I really like you for watching this vlog. Remember to subscribe and hit the like button. And we'll see you for the Forest game at the Cherries. Love you, Dembele.